Good evening and welcome back, students. What we have been talking is about redox processes. What we have been discussing with you students,
redox processes.
Okay, thank you very much for reminding me. And we have been telling you about oxidation number. I hope you are familiar with how to calculate oxidation number, student. This is very important. Now the entire chapter will be based on this. In fact, chemistry reactions are all going to be decided by the oxidation number concept. So you have already been given in the last lectures how to find oxidation numbers of elements in a compound. In any compound, we can find the oxidation number. Yes or no, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay, the oxidation numbers can be determined, student. That's a important point. That we are now in a position to find the oxidation number. Why this is going to be a very, very important topic. And in fact, the chemistry is going to be explained on the basis of oxidation number concepts. Now we are going to talk today, students, oxidation and reduction, oxidation and reduction, using in terms of oxidation number, how? Let us see number three. I am saying you already know electronic definition of oxidation, student. What is oxidation? Electronic definition. Oxidation is
reduction of electrons.
Oxidation is loss of electrons.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And students, reduction is gain of electrons, right?
Yes, sir.
Gain of electrons. Therefore, what will happen if something is oxidized? For example, if I write Ni, you are saying it is undergoing oxidation, means it is losing electrons.
Yes, sir.
If I write something like this, students, what it means? You are saying nickel has undergone oxidation.
Yes, sir, it has.
So what is the oxidation state of nickel here in an element? What is the oxidation state here? We have already given you the rules. This oxidation number is zero. And what is the oxidation number of nickel here? Plus two. So what has happened if there is an oxidation, student? There's a increase in oxidation number. Yes or no?
Yes.
Oxidation will mean increase in oxidation number, students. This is a definition, yes, which we are now giving the definition of oxidation and reduction in terms of oxidation number. Oxidation will mean increase in oxidation. Increase in oxidation, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if I say there is a reduction, for example, reduction is gain of electron, you are saying reduction is gain of electron, student. This is an ion, it gains two electron. What happens? It becomes. So in this case, what is the oxidation number of copper here? Plus two. And what is the oxidation number of copper here? Zero. So what has happened? This is a reduction. There's a decrease in oxidation number. Any doubt?
No, sir.
This definition is clear. Whenever there will be an increase in oxidation number of an element in a reaction, what will happen? We'll say oxidation. That element is oxidized. And if there is a decrease in oxidation number of the element, student, what I will say? This example of reduction. For example, you are saying manganese, for example, you are saying there is an element manganese, student. It is going from 7 plus to Mn2 plus. So what it means, what has happened to the oxidation state, student? Increased or decreased? What is this? Increase or decrease in oxidation state? Tell me, students. What is this? Increase or decrease?
In this, the oxidation is decreasing.
What is decreasing? I am saying oxidation number was
oxidation
plus 7, it has become plus
decreasing.
2. Therefore, it is example of oxidation or reduction.
Reduction.
This has been reduced. Mn 7 plus has been reduced. You are saying it has undergone reduction, reduced. It is reduced, student, because the oxidation number has decreased. Has it decreased? Yes or
yes,
no?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Then these are some of the examples which we are giving. Examples we are giving in terms of the definition of oxidation and reduction in terms of the oxidation number, students. You are saying Cl2 plus 2e, it gives 2Cl minus. What it means? What has happened to Cl2? Is it oxidized or reduced?
Cl2 is reduced.
What is the oxidation number of Cl2 here? 0. What is
zero
here? Minus 1.
Minus 1.
So 0 to minus 1, there's a decrease in oxidation number. Decrease in oxidation means that Cl2 is
has been reduced.
It is reduced. So we have started talking of oxidation and reduction, students, in terms of the oxidation number. This is an important point. We will be discussing reactions and trying to find out which is oxidized and which is reduced. And you know that redox reactions are those reactions in which oxidation and reduction takes place. You are aware of that?
Yes, sir.
What I told you about redox reaction, students. Redox reactions are those
where oxidation and reduction both occur.
Oxidation and reduction both occur, both take place.
Yes.
Oxidation and reduction take place
simultaneously.
Simultaneously, of course, in a reaction, both the things should be present. Then only it is an example of oxidation and reduction. We call them as redox reaction, redox reaction, students. And in a redox reaction, we can identify. We can identify which is oxidized and which is reduced by using the oxidation number. Yes or no? We can identify. We can identify the element oxidized or reduced, students, using oxidation number. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. So let us take some examples of these, students, then. Example. I am writing a reaction, student. I am saying Br2, this is my bromine. Br2 is reacting with SO2. SO2 in the presence of water, students, and I am getting H2SO4. I am getting H2SO4 and 2HBr. Now you have to identify which is oxidized and which is reduced. Now we are saying identify. What do you have to identify? The elements have been oxidized and reduced. Oxidized and reduced. Okay, you have 1 minute.
Sir.
You have 1 minute to answer the question. How will you attempt the question? You have to first find the oxidation number of each element in a compound on the reactant side and on the product side. And if there is an increase in oxidation number, you will say this is oxidized. If there's a decrease in oxidation number, you will say, okay, this element is reduced. Okay, you try it, then I will do it.
Identify. H2O.
Have 1 minute, students, to answer that question. Everything involves thinking, and the rules which we have given you for finding the oxidation number. Your first thing will be to give oxidation number to each element in these compounds, in these reactant, as well as in the products. Then I will be able to see that, students, see that what is changing and what is not changing.
So for H2O, the oxidation number will be H will be plus 1 and O will be minus 2.
I'm going to do it here. You can see and help me if I am asking to help you, students. This is a reaction given in the exam. Tell me, what is the oxidation number of Br in Br2?
Br is...
What are the rules which we told
what
you?
What is the group for Br2?
What are the oxidation numbers of Br2, bromine in Br2, students?
Yes, sir.
This Br2?
Yes.
What is the oxidation number of
group 17? So,
this
oxidation
will
number will be 7?
What 7? But what you have been told?
Oh, 0.
0. This is an element? Oxidation
yes.
number will be 0.
Yeah.
Oxidation number 0 of Br in Br2, 0. Let me come to this. What is the oxidation number of sulfur in SO2?
O2 is minus 2. Wait, no. O is minus 2.
What and is the oxidation number of sulfur in SO2?
Wait, let me check.
If this is X, this is how many two oxygens? One is minus 2 equal to 0. So what is the value coming?
2.
Minus 2, then this is plus 4.
Plus 4.
What is here? This is hydrogen is plus 1, this is minus 2. What is the oxidation number here of sulfur?
Sulfur plus 4?
How you are saying plus 4? Without calculating, can I do it, students? You have to calculate everything.
SO4 always minus 2. H is plus 1.
What is the value? This is equal to 0. What is the value of X?
2 plus X plus 8 minus 8. 2 plus 6.
Plus 6. Plus 1, minus 2. Here, what is the oxidation state of Br?
So, H is plus 1. 1 plus... Br will be... minus 1?
What is the problem? Plus 1, then it has to be minus 1. What is the difficulty? Now let us see, this Br2 has shifted from where it is gone. 0 to minus 1. What do you mean by 0 to minus 1? There is an increase or decrease in oxidation number.
Yes, it is reduction.
What is this?
Reduction.
Reduction. Reduction. Why decrease in what oxidation number? Clear? What happens
Yes.
to sulfur then? What happens to sulfur, students?
Sulfur is being oxidized.
This is my sulfur, student. Which oxidation state it is going? Sulfur is going from plus 4 to plus 6. Sulfur is
oxidized. Yes, sir.
Sulfur is oxidized. Sulfur,
yes, sir,
is oxidized, students.
Yeah.
So here in this reaction, there is a Br2 is being reduced.
Yes, sir.
And sulfur is being oxidized.
Yes.
So Br2 is being reduced. In this reaction, you can say that in this reaction, you are saying Br2 is being reduced. And sulfur is being oxidized.
Yes, sir.
So this is an example of redox reaction. Is an example of redox reaction. Is a simul and reduction. That means it is example of the redox reaction. It's example of the redox reaction.
Yes, sir.
Example of the redox reaction.
Yeah.
So now we have started working on the reaction, student. Reaction, this is very important part of the chemistry. Any doubt? Again repeatedly tell the students, keep on revising with me, students. Keep on revising your notes. Now we are coming to very, very important part of chemistry. You will learn chemistry if you start knowing the oxidation numbers, and you will see what type of reactions we are doing. Redox reactions are those in which oxidation and reduction takes place, and further there could be reaction in which there is no change in the oxidation number. Let us see more examples of these, students. Okay. All right, now we are giving you another example, student. Here, what you see, I am giving an example of another redox reaction, students. You have to identify the elements oxidized, reduced. Okay, using oxidation number. What do you have to use? Oxidation. Clear?
Yes.
All right. That equation is right on the board, student. I am writing this equation. You are reacting hydroxide ion with chlorine, student, and I am giving the product 5Cl minus, student, plus ClO3 minus, student, and 3H2O. You have 1 minute to answer the question, students.
Okay. COH minus 6OH minus plus 3Cl2. Cl2 is 0. OH minus is 0 minus.
Step 1 is what?
Cl2 is 0 oxidation number.
Step 1 is always assign oxidation numbers.
Yes, sir.
To every element. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Oh, very good. Then you are saying this Cl2.
Easy.
Otherwise, also if you see Cl, they are the same atoms. So what if there is no transfer of charge? There is nothing, no plus or minus here because they are the same zero. Okay, very good. What happens in OH minus? What happens in OH minus student? What happens in OH minus? OH minus student. This is OH minus.
OH minus is
Hydrogen is plus one and
plus
oxygen
one.
is minus two because minus two plus one
It'll
will be
be
minus one.
plus one, minus
What is
one.
the charge on the Cl student here?
Minus one.
Minus one, the oxidation number. And what is the oxidation number of Cl here?
CL here is chlorine is
Minus one.
minus one.
I'm talking, they are not here.
Okay.
This is zero. What is the oxidation number of Cl here? You can calculate by using X. What is
X O is plus 2,
X
so X
minus
plus
2 into 3 equal to minus 1.
minus 1.
So what is the value of X?
X is minus 1 plus 6 minus 4 plus 5.
Plus 5. And this is hydrogen plus 1 and oxygen is minus 2.
Minus 2.
So here we have written the oxidation numbers of every element student. Theek hai?
Yes, sir.
Now, what has happened to this Cl2 here?
It
This has
is,
increased
it
or
has been
decreased?
reduced.
What is that known as?
A reduction.
Reduction. Very good. So you understood the idea. And again, what is happening here?
It has been oxidized.
Increase
Increase
oxidation.
oxidation.
So here is a example of a redox reaction. In this reaction, same species, which is the same species student Cl, same species Cl, it is being reduced and oxidized. Theek hai?
Yes, sir.
Same species is being reduced and oxidized.
Oxidized.
Theek hai?
Yes,
It's
sir.
the same reaction. The same reaction. This question has been asked in the paper, is very important. Student, note down, such reactions are known as disproportionation reaction. This is
Yes,
called
sir.
disproportionation reaction. This is a very, very important question in the exam, student.
Yes, sir.
Such reactions are called disproportionation reaction, that the same element is being oxidized and reduced, students, and reduced. Any doubt?
Yes, sir. No, sir.
You have noted down everything?
No, sir. I'm writing it down still.
Write down because this is a very important question. This question will come in your paper.
I wrote it, sir.
All right, we are coming to another important question because with questions, when we do practice na, we understand more concept easily. Because in exam also you will get a question, student. Now we have a question for you. We are giving you a reaction CR2O7 2 minus reacts with H2O students, the product to CrO4, 2 minus and 2H plus. The question is this a redox reaction?
Yes, sir.
Question has been asked in the paper. You have 1 minute to answer the question, students. Steps have been told. How do you answer the question? You are so well aware.
This is a redox reaction. Okay. Cr2O6. So plus 2. Sorry, minus 2. 2, 7. Wait. Minus 14. X plus. Cr is minus 14 and over here minus 2008 minus 10 that's 2.0. No, sir, it is not a redox reaction.
Not a redox reaction? How do you know that?
In this force, Cr2O72 minus plus H2O, Cr2 is.
What is minus... the oxidation number of Cr here? You have, if it is X, then you have 2 into X plus 7 into minus 2 equal to minus 2. What is the value of X then? 2X is equal to minus 2 plus 14. 2X is equal to plus 12. X is equal to plus 6.
Plus 6.
So this is in plus 6 oxidation state.
Yes, sir.
Oxygen is then in minus 2. This is minus 2. Hydrogen is plus 1. Now here, let us see in this compound, student. You have X plus 4 into minus 2. This is charge is 2
it's
minus.
It's equal to plus 2.
So
wait, that's minus 2.
How much? X minus 2 plus 8 plus 6. This is also plus 6. This is minus 2. This is plus 1. Therefore, what do we find, students? No change.
It is not a redox reaction.
In oxidation number of any element. Therefore, it is not a redox reaction. Right or wrong?
You are right, sir.
Right, sir. Therefore, we are saying for a reaction to be a redox reaction, there must involve a change in oxidation number. For what is the condition for a redox reaction? What is the condition for a redox reaction, student? For a redox reaction, there must be change in oxidation number. Clear? Yeah, we'll ask what is the condition? What is the condition for a reaction to be redox, student?
It has to be both oxidation and reduction.
I said, what is the condition? I have written it here. There must be a change in?
There must be a change in
oxidation
number. Oxidation number.
Okay. Noted? Everything should be noted, student. Notes will help you in the exam. I will proceed further. Can I proceed further, students?
Yes, sir.
If you have doubt, you can stop me. Now, we are talking oxidizing and reducing agents. Reducing agents. Agent, what is an agent? You are saying he is an LIC agent. He will, you will go to him, give money, and he will make your insurance. He will make your insurance. He is an agent. So when I say it is an oxidizing agent, you are saying oxidizing agent means what?
An agent that oxidizes.
Which will oxidize the other element. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And if it will oxidize the other element, it will get reduced.
Yes, sir, it will.
It will get reduced. And when a reduction takes place, it will gain electron.
Yeah.
It will gain student or attract, or it will attract electrons. It will get the electrons. It will remove, it will gain, you are saying, we have written two times here. It will gain, you are saying, electrons. So it will snatch electrons from the others. That's what you are saying. Similarly, what will be a reducing agent, student?
Reducing agent will be something that reduces the element.
It will reduce the other, you are saying. And then it will get oxidized. That means it will give electrons. It will give electrons. Yes or no? So yes, there are two things. One is oxidizing agent, other is reducing agent. One is oxidizing agent, other is a reducing agent. These are also called oxidants.
That, okay.
And reductants. And reductant. Definition clear, student? Clear. Theek hai? So oxidizing agent will be that which will get reduced, which will take the electrons from other, which will take the electrons from other. So we are saying question for you now. When we do question, we understand more. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Br minus x with Cl2, students, you are getting 2Cl minus Br2. We are saying, student, identify oxidizing, yes, and a reducing agent in the reaction. In the you are given a reaction, you have to identify the oxidizing and reducing agent, student.
Okay, sir. Working on that. So Br plus.
Always I say step one is assign oxidation
assign number. Oxidation number.
To reactants and products.
Br and is out. Going to be zero. Cl2 is going to be, wait. Yeah, Br is also going to be zero. Cl2 is going to be zero. Oh no, Br is minus one. CO2 is zero. So, oxidizing agent is Cl2 and reducing agent is Br2.
Okay, let me write down Br minus Cl2 is giving 2 Cl minus plus Br2. Let me assign the oxidation number, students. Oxidation number. What is the oxidation number of here?
Minus one, zero.
Therefore, Br minus goes to this. This is increase or decrease?
Increase.
Increase. This is being oxidized. And what happens to the Cl?
Reduced.
Therefore, this oxidized is a reducing agent.
Yes, sir.
And Cl2 is a
oxidizing agent.
Oxidizing agent. This is our oxidizing agent. Clear?
Clear, sir.
So here, chlorine is oxidizing agent.
Yes, sir.
And Br minus is reducing agent. Sure?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Note it down.
I'll just write it down, sir.
Okay, write down everything. Will help you in the exam, students.
Wait, sir, still writing.
Okay, write down.
Okay, sir, written, sir.
Okay, thank you. Good. You are doing good, but practice will require is required for you students. We are doing a lot of questions, a lot of practice questions. The purpose is to be able to help you. Okay, question coming on the screen for us. Identify oxidizing and reducing agent in the reaction. What the reaction is given student to us, what the reaction is given to a student, important Cr2O7. This ion we give a lot in the question paper, student, give a lot in the question paper, is reacting with ferrous ion, aqueous. In the chemistry we use this a lot, acidic medium, H plus aqueous. You know what is an acid, H plus. The products are chromium ions, aqueous 3 plus 6 Fe. There are iron 3 plus, and you are getting 7 H2O liquid. Student, this is a question before you on the screen. You will find out the oxidizing and reducing agent. You are given 1 minute for answering the question, students.
Okay. My internet is slow. Cr2O7, 2 minutes.
The first step is assign oxidation number to every element.
Yeah, sir.
Okay, do
I'm
it.
I'm doing that. X plus 7 2 is equal to minus 2. Then 14, then minus 2 plus 14, which will be 2 plus 14. You multiply 2, it's 2x. So
first oxidation
with
chromium.
Chromium is
2 into
plus 6
x plus 7 into minus 2.
Chromium become plus 6.
So what is the value of x coming, student? Minus 2. Minus 2 plus 14 is plus 12. X is equal to
Plus six.
The oxidation number of chromium plus 6, oxygen minus 2. Iron oxidation number already given. 2 plus, plus 2.
2 plus.
Hydrogen
then
plus.
Then H is plus 1.
This is plus 3.
See,
and this is okay. Plus 3. This is minus 2. This is plus 1. All oxidation number listed.
Cr2 is oxidizing agent.
So we what we are saying, Cr2O minus 2 minus, this is going from plus 6 to
plus 3.
3 plus, plus 6, 2 plus 3. So this is and plus 2 to this. I will change the plus. Plus 6, 2 plus 3.
Yes, sir.
Plus 3. Therefore, chromium, this is undergoing.
Yeah.
Oxidation or reduction?
It is undergoing reduction.
Reduction. And iron. What is happening to iron, student?
Iron is being oxidized. So iron will be the reducing agent.
Plus 2 to plus 3. This is undergoing oxidation. So we can say that Cr2O7 2 minus acts as an oxidizing agent, student.
Yes, sir.
Answer. And iron 2 plus acts as reducing agent.
Yes, sir, it does.
Does that answer our question?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. So good. We understood everything so easily, so easily. So everything is changing and evolving. The idea of oxidation and reduction was originally in terms of oxygen and hydrogen. Now we have started talking in terms of the loss and gain of electrons. All the thing we are talking oxidation and reduction in terms of the electronic definition, student. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Oh, so good. So good, student. Okay. Now, I said redox equations. What are redox equations, student?
Redox equations are where both oxidation and reduction occur.
We can, student, break the redox equation in two halves. What we can do? In two half equations. This will make our job easy and simple. Now we are coming to that point. The half equations, we can say, oxidation half reaction and second reduction half reaction. Every equation we can split up in two things, reduction half reaction. Any redox reaction we can say is made up of two half reactions. There is an oxidation half reaction and there is a reduction half reaction. For example, student, when I said ki Cr2O7 2 minus aqueous reacts with 6Fe2 plus aqueous, students, and you are having 14H plus aqueous, students. What is the result? You are getting 2Cr3 plus aqueous and you are getting 6Fe3 plus aqueous, students. And what you got was 7H2O liquid. This is a complete reaction?
Yes, sir.
This is a redox reaction, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Just now you have told me it is a redox reaction in which dichromate ion is acting as an oxidizing agent and ferrous 2 plus is acting as a reducing agent. You have answered the question.
Yes, sir.
Let me say, right, one part of it, oxidation half reaction. Where is the oxidation taking place, student? I am saying 6Fe2 plus is undergoing oxidation to 6Fe3 plus. Okay?
Yes, sir.
This iron is being oxidized.
Yeah.
If I cancel this, it is clear what I am saying. this is Fe2 plus is going to Fe3 plus. So to balance it, where is the electron to be added? This side or this side? Electron is negative.
Yeah.
This is positive. So this is losing. This is this Fe3 plus, Fe3 plus. Fe2 plus will lose one electron. Then it will form Fe3 plus. So this is example of oxidation.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Oxidation. Okay. Then second, you are saying, sir, reduction half reaction. Reduction half reaction, students. Where is that, student? You are saying Cr2O7 minus. You are saying Cr2O minus 7, students. What is happening to that, student? Cr2O minus 7, it is shifting to where it is going, Cr2O minus 7.
It is going to
second one.
What, sir?
Which is the second one? Here, Cr2O 7, 2 minus. This is going to where it is going. Cr2O
7. Cr2O 7.
2 chromium 3 plus.
Yeah.
This is the second reaction, student. This is the second reaction which we have shown here. Second reaction.
Yes, sir.
So here, what is happening to Cr2O7 minus? You are saying Cr2O7 2 minus this aqueous. It is reacting with 14H plus aqueous. What is the product? 2Cr3 plus aqueous and 7H2O liquid.
Yes, sir.
Now, how many charges are there? This is 2 minus. This is 14 plus.
Yes, sir.
Minus 2 and 14 plus. How much is that? Plus 12. Plus 12. But there are two chromiums. How many? 2. Plus 12. You have seen Cr2. This is plus 12. This is how much? 2 into plus 3 plus 6.
Yeah.
Plus 6 charge. This is plus 12. So where should I add the electron so that charges become equal in both the cases, students?
Plus, you should add in the plus 6 to...
So 6 electrons added to make this. So
yes, sir.
This is a addition of electron. Therefore, it is example of the reduction.
Yes, sir.
Example of the reduction. This is example of the oxidation. Therefore, we can always split students the reactions. We can always split the reactions into halves. Now, if we have to complete the reaction, how will we complete this reaction? This is my one reaction. This is my other reaction. Iron is undergoing oxidation. Potassium dichromate is undergoing reduction. When we will balance, the reaction, student, or when we will write the complete reaction, write the complete redox reaction, what is the story? The thing, important point is the one is donating the electron, other is gaining the electron. So therefore, yes, the number of electrons given by one must be equal to number of electrons gained by the other. Yes or no? If this is giving one electron, this needs 6 electrons. So who will give 6 electrons? This one. So we have to multiply this by 6. That is why we get 6 Fe, 6 and 6 electrons. If I multiply this by 6, what I will get? 6 Fe, 2 plus 6 Fe, and you will get 6 electrons. Yes or no? If I multiply this equation by 6, what is the result, student? You will get 6 Fe, 2 plus. This was aqueous, so I put it aqueous, no problem. And what you will get? 6 Fe, 3 plus How many electrons? Six.
Six.
So that now what can happen? There are six electrons on the right hand side, six on the left. If you will add the two, add
it
the
will become equal.
If I add these two equations, one and two, then these electrons will cancel out. This six electrons and six cancel out. And then you get the same equation which we have written.
Okay. Right? Yes, sir.
So what we have shown here, student, what we have shown here, very simple thing, that we can write any reaction, we can write any reaction in terms of the two half reactions. One will be oxidation and other will be reduction. Other will be reduction. So these are called oxidation half reaction and reduction half reactions.
Yes, sir.
This will help us in balancing the reactions, which will be our next topic, how to balance these reactions. We can take one more example. One more example is coming, student. We are saying, write the oxidation half and reduction half reactions.
Yeah.
Why we are doing it? Because after this, we are going to the balancing of the reaction. Here, one question will come in the paper, how to balance the redox reaction. That's the most important thing. First,
yes,
for that, we have to be able to write this. Therefore, we are giving a question that you are having Br2 plus SO2 plus 2H2O, students. H2SO4 plus 2HBr. You have to write two reactions, oxidation and reduction, oxidation and reduction in this case. Separate them in terms of oxidation and reduction.
Okay. Br is zero here.
This is clear what is happening?
Yeah.
Which is a, there are two separate reactions.
This Br and HBr, SO2 and
minus one.
Yeah.
This sulfur is how much? Plus four. And this is plus six. You can see?
Yes, sir.
The two reactions. This is undergoing reduction. This is undergoing
oxidation.
Oxidation. Now we have to separate the two reactions and write the answer. You have 1 minute. I have already simplified the story.
Okay, so give me a minute. I'm just writing it down.
Okay. So I'm saying oxidation half reaction. What is the oxidation half reaction, student? SO2 is going to H2SO4. And you have 2H2O. 2H2O here?
Yes, sir.
That means what is happening, student, here? If I have 2H2O, what it will give me? H2SO4, how many oxygen? 4. Here, how many oxygen? 2 and 2, 4 oxygen.
Yes, sir.
Here you have 2 hydrogen, here you have 4. So it will be, then what will be that? You need 2 more hydrogens, that will be 2H plus. 2H plus. How many sulfur? 1. You have to balance the number of atoms and charges. Balance the number of
yes,
atoms
sir.
And charges. Sulfur 1, oxygen 2 plus 2, 4, hydrogen 2 plus 2, 4, but charge plus 2. So there will be 2 electrons.
Yeah.
Plus 2 and minus 2 will be 0, na?
Yes, sir, it will be 0.
Charge is balanced, what I'm saying. Each half reaction, charge balanced. Atoms
yes,
balanced. If you have water on one side, there is H plus on the other side. The reaction takes place in acidic medium or some, let us see. This is okay, equation one.
Yes, sir, it is.
This is my equation one, student. Second, I am saying reduction half reaction. Because in next step will be balancing. By this method, we will go to balance the reactions. Reduction half reaction, which is the reduction half reaction, student number two. Br2 is getting reduced to 2HBr. Now, this has Br2, this has 2Br, but H, so I will put 2H plus. But I'm putting 2H plus. So hydrogen balanced, Br balanced, but there is charge plus 2. So in order to balance that, you add 2 electrons.
Yes, sir.
Reduction. So now there are two equations. If I add the two, the secret is the charge should be cancelled. Electrons we have to cancel, student. What we have to cancel?
Yes, sir.
This has two electrons, this has two electrons, no problem. Cancelled. ठीक है? This has two H plus, this has two H plus, also cancelled. Oh, what is
yes,
left? SO2 plus Br2. ठीक है?
Yes, sir.
There are two H2O. It is giving me what? H2SO4 plus 2HBr. Right? Got it?
Yes, sir.
So this is the way, students, how do we find oxidizing agent, reducing agent, and this will provide us a method of balancing of the redox reaction, which will be our next lecture when we will meet you, students. I hope you understood everything and have noted everything. Any doubt is there, you can ask me, students. You have any doubt?
No doubt, sir. No doubt.
Noted?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then. Good night. Thank you very much for interacting with me. One thing is, the secret of our success will lie in how much hard work we will put, students. The more hard work, the more practice, the more confidence will be there for the results. Otherwise, we will be doing some minor mistakes in the paper, students, and we'll lose marks. Is it right or wrong, students?
Right, sir.
Okay, then. Good night. Bye-bye. I'll meet you in my next class.
Good night.
Good night.